हेलो गाइस, नाउ वी आर डूइंग सम बोर्ड कैलिब्रेशंस. ओके, नाउ माय नेम इज़ पंकज. अगेन वी आर एक्सप्लेनिंग अगेन वी आर कमिंग हेयर टू एक्सप्लेन यू द बोर्ड कैलिब्रेशन. आई हैव अ टू ट्रांसमीटर, यू कैन सी हियर. वन फर्स्ट वन इज़ योर फ्लाई स्काई मॉडल नंबर FST6AB एंड सेकेंड वन इज़ रेडियो ने. बट इन दिस वीडियो वी आर यूजिंग दिस ट्रांसमीटर एंड वी विल शो यू सम बोर्ड कैलिब्रेशन प्रोसेस इन अ क्वाडकॉप्टर. ओके, now what is the basic requirement for your board calibration? You need a one receiver, and I have a one fly sky transmitter. Already I told you that this is my board. Okay, I will show you one more board. This is one more board. Okay, I'm using this board, and this board is controller. This controller is at Mega 168 PA. okay, and I fixes this board in here. Now here, look, this motor is my clockwise direction. Okay, this motor is my clockwise direction. Second one is my anti clock anti. Okay, so this is my board is fixed here, and you know very well your first motor should be your clockwise, second motor is your anti clockwise, third one is again clock, and fourth one is your clockwise. Now look, what we will do. First we will connect our receiver in this board. Okay, I'm using this one. These are the receiver. In receiver you can sir, can you zoom it? Okay, now look here, in receiver bat is written in a top, then after that CS6, CS5, channel number 4, channel number 3, channel number 2, channel 1. Okay, channel 1 is connected to your aileron, channel 2 is elevator, channel number 3 is throttle, and channel number 4 is for rudder purpose. Okay, so we are only using four channel here, four basic channel in a quadcopter. And listen here, your first pins, these first pins, okay, these all first pins towards your antenna, all are signal pins. Middle one is your VCC, and last one is your ground. Okay, again I am explaining, these all are signal pins, middle one VCC and third one is ground. Okay, now what we are going to do here, I am connecting my first channel. In my first channel, you look here, white one is signal wire, so this is towards your antenna, middle one is VCC, and third one is your ground. So all are parallel connection, so no need to give a supply in every channel, only single time I am giving a supply VCC and ground. Okay, now I am connecting this channel number one in our board, channel number one. This one is, first one is my aileron, second one is my elevator, third one is throttle, and fourth one is my rudder. Okay, so now rest of the connection, I already told you that only one time I'm giving a VCC and ground supply, and the rest of the pin I'm using as a signal pin. Okay, so white means second channel connected here, I think it's good. Third one is my throttle purpose, that's finish, and fourth one is again for rudder. These my channel connection. Now this is my receiver connection. Okay, my receiver is connected. Okay, first one is aileron, second one is elevator, third one is throttle, and fourth one is rudder. Okay, now Sundar sir will explain you the some motor connection. Okay,
now we're going to calibrate this board as well as ESCs as well as the motors all together, and for that there's a three potentiometers here. You can see your page and roll. And for the calibration process, you have to put this potentiometer in minimum. Minimum means you have to rotate to the clockwise. Counterclockwise. At a certain point, it will tend to stop. There's no more rotation. That is a minimum point. And if you rotate in a counterclockwise, you can see that it is an now it's in maximum 100 position, and it's 0 and it's in 100. For the calibration process, it should be in minimum. I'm putting my yaw potentiometer at 0.
So your potential should be in a minimum position.
Yes. After that, make sure your ESCs are connected properly. Similar to the receiver connection, here are the ESC pins, ESC 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And it will be indicated as M1, M2, M3, M4, M5, M6. Here you can see the things. Here it's written S for signal pins. These are the signal pins, and these are the positive VCC, and this is the ground. Okay, make sure you're connecting the clockwise motor, which is first this motor ESCs, to this pin M1, and always make sure your connection white is always a signal pin, red is a positive, and black one is a negative, it's ground. And now I'm connecting the second one, and I'm connecting now the third one and the final fourth motor. Okay, this is the connection from the receiver to this, and this is the ESC connections. After making connections, once again you check all the is any pins are left unconnected. Okay, then after connecting all these things, you put your potentiometer in zero minimum. It is in minimum. This video is all about calibrating your board as well as electronic speed controller as well as motors, right? So we'll have to switch on your transmitter before calibration process. Switch it on and put your throttle in maximum. This is the third channel. This is the first one, aileron, and this is elevator, and this is throttle, third one, and this is rudder, which is a fourth channel. I'm putting my throttle in maximum, and after putting the throttle in maximum, you just check your battery and connect it. Once if I connect this, you should notice this LED blink. I'm connecting now. Once it's the calibration process now started. Now it's end. So you have to put your throttle in minimum now. Once you put all this throttle in minimum, the process, calibration process is over. If you raise the throttle, your all motors should run simultaneously.
Sorry, I think this one. Okay, this look, guys. Receiver is not bind with this transmitter. Okay, just wait.
Sorry, I think that's the transmitter.
No, not this one. Yo, sorry,
yeah,
guys.
Sorry, guys. We actually misplaced the transmitter. There are two transmitters.
Similar transmitters. Okay.
So we had kind of little confusions. And this is the third channel. Now you can see this. If you increase the throttle, all motors are running simultaneously. Alright. Hence the calibration process is over.
So what is the rule of pitch and yaw?
Yeah, your potentiometer is for calibrating the board. So if you want to reset this settings, if you have to make the sticks value center, for that purpose you have to disconnect the battery and put your potentiometer, your potentiometer at maximum 100. Put it at 100, and then make your pitch potentiometer to zero. Now it's in 50, I'm putting it in to zero. It's in minimum now. So after putting all these things together, now make sure all the sticks are center, including the trim values. These are the trim values. Make sure all the trims are set to center, and everything is stick, every stick is center. After that, just connect the battery and notice the board now. And it's a process started now. Wait for a few seconds and hence the process over. Just disconnect the battery, that's all. Now the trim values and stick values are centered. Now you can adjust the value whatever you want. Now I'm going to test this quad now, and don't forget to put the pitch potentiometer back to 50, the value, the back value, right? So hence calibration process is over, as well as stick centering.
So can
is
you
over.
Arm this motor, because we done the calibration process, so now we are going to arm this board.
Yeah, arming is the process which we will be arming, which will enter into flying mode. While in the calibration mode, you cannot activate the controls like pitch and roll. During flying, arming.
First, we will keep the yaw axis in a maximum.
Yeah, yaw axis should be in maximum, and the pitch value is 50 and roll is 50.
Okay.
After that, connect the battery. Now all the values are centered, so you'll get a beep sounds like this. And then arming is, now I'm going to arm my board because I have to enter into flying mode. For that, hold your third channel to this corner. Look at the board now.
Look at the board. It's in a arm position. Okay. A blue light indicating your quad is in flying mode.
It's in flying mode. If you increase the throttle, your motors will be running. Okay. So if you are to check whether the gyroscopes are working properly, take your quad in hand and just rotate this. Can you notice the sound difference?
Yeah, the speed variation in a motor.
Yeah, due to the speed variations, it produces sound. Hence, your board is in a perfect condition.
It means that all the sensor is in working condition.
Yeah,
all the gyros
is working fine. So, next, the final step is just you have to check the directions of motor. For that, again, arm the board and increase the throttle. Now we have to check whether our elevator channel are proper, normal, it's reversed. For that, just hold the motor and check whether if you are giving an elevator, make sure your motor 3 and 4 gets increased. And for the elevator back, your motor 1 and 2 should rise. Similarly for the right aileron, these two motors speed will increase. Yeah. And for the left, these two speed. And for clockwise, you can see these counterclockwise motors speed increases. And for counterclockwise, this motor clockwise speed get increased. Hence, your quad is now ready to fly. Okay. And just on it.
Okay.